Hello everyone, welcome to your very own channel Sony Sync Physics. In this video, I am going to discuss about speed time graph. You will see the questions which will help you to understand how to calculate gradient for a graph which is passing through origin or if it is a curve. Both the examples are there and I have explained in a very simple way. The whole concept you are going to see through questions. So let us watch the questions.
This is the first question in front of you. What does the horizontal line on the speed time graph indicates? And the correct answer is indicates constant speed. Next question is, what is happening during point A to B? So if you look at point A to B, this is point A and this is point B. So this is a horizontal line parallel to the time axis. So here we can say that the speed is constant. So the correct answer will be the object is moving with constant speed. Next question, what is happening to the car between 3 and 8 seconds? So between 3 and 8 seconds, this is 3 seconds and this is 8 seconds. Again, this is a horizontal line parallel to the time axis. So here also we will say object is moving with constant speed. We'll see next question here. What does the speed time graph below represent the object as? So here this is the speed time graph and here we have to see that what is the meaning of this. So if you look at this one, this is acceleration part. This is accelerating and here object is moving with the constant speed. So that will be the answer. Accelerating then traveling at constant speed. We'll see next question. What is the area under the speed time graph equal to? So the area under the speed time graph, suppose we are going to draw a graph, this is speed time graph. So suppose this is the graph, we have to find out what is the meaning of the area under the graph. So area under the graph represents, you know what? It represents the distance cover or displacement. Next question. In the velocity time graph below, what does the section of the graph below the time axis refers to? So the section of the graph below the time axis. So what it means? It means that object is traveling in the opposite direction to the initial motion. We'll see next question. Using the graph, calculate the total distance traveled by the motorcycle. So here, as you have seen before, to calculate total distance, we need to calculate area under the graph. So here the graph is equally divided into two right angle triangle and one rectangle. So we'll calculate area of each and then we will add it. So we'll do a little bit calculation over here. So for the first section, it is right angle triangle. So area will be equal to half into B into H and that will be equal to half into B will be 20 and H will be 25. So it will be 250 meter in the first section. Then second part, it will be L into B. That is equal to what? 50 minus 20, that will be equal to 30 into 25. So it is 750 meter. Then last will be again triangle. So that is half into B into H. That is half into B is 10 and H is 25, so it will be 125 meter. You might be wondering that how I am doing meter. It is area and then I am writing meter over here. So I will show you half into B. B is what? B is base. So base is our time, that is second, into H. H is our speed, that is meter by second. So when you multiply this, second will get cancelled and will leave the unit with meter. So that's what I am writing meter over here. So total distance will be equal to 250 plus 750 plus 125. So that will be equal to 1125 meter. So this is the distance covered under this graph. We'll see next question. In this question, what is the displacement of the object shown in the velocity time graph? So here also we need to calculate the displacement. And in this graph, the graph is above the time axis and below the time axis. So we have to see how to calculate displacement over here. We'll follow the same method what we did before. We'll calculate area under the graph. So for the first section, it will be equal to half into B into H, and B will be 15, and H, I just assume that I will take 12 meter per second. So here also, if you look at, since it is below time axis, so here also we can take 12 meter per second, but that will be negative. So then in the first section, for this part, it will be half into B will be 15 and H 12. So the answer will be 90 meter in the first section, and in the next section it will be half into B will be, again since it is 30, so 30 minus 15, it will be 15 second. So 15 into H will be, this is our H, so that will be minus 12. So here minus 90 meter. So the total displacement will be equal to 90 plus minus 90 meters, so that will be equal to 0. So in this case, displacement will be equal to 0. We'll see next question. Here, what is the slope of a line on a velocity time graph and indication of? So the slope indicates acceleration. Suppose this is our velocity time graph, and this is the graph here. This slope indicates acceleration. In this question, at what point is the speed greatest? So the speed is greatest at point C. Here, which of the following scenarios has caused the motion described by the graph? So if you look at all these options, then the correct answer will be an object rolling up a slope, then returning to its original position. So this is the scenario shown by this graph. Here we are going to see average of curved graph. So how to calculate average gradient? Why we need to find out average gradient? Because you know this graph is a curve, and there will be many places where the gradient will differ. So we need to find out average gradient. And I have shared one example also here. A speed time graph of first 4 seconds of someone running a race is shown. So this is the graph. And then I think I need to change the pen color. What do you like? Red. Okay, we'll go with red. So since you can see there are multiple slopes over here, so we can find out the average slope. So the question is, calculate the average acceleration over 4 seconds. So we'll see how we'll do that. We know the gradient of the line, that will be equal to acceleration. And to work out average acceleration over the 4 seconds, we will draw a line from where the graph is 0, 0 to where the time we have to find out. So this line we have drawn from the 0, 0 to the end of the graph. So we will get as a gradient 6 minus 0 divided by 4 minus 0. That will be equal to 1.5 meter per second square. So here to calculate this, we should know the formula for gradient. That will be equal to gradient is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, sorry, x1. So here y2 will be this point. So when you take this point here, this will be y2, then this will be y1, this will be point x2, and this will be same 0, 0 will be point x1. So in this way, we will calculate gradient of curve. Next question is, instantaneous gradient of a curve. So in the previous one, we calculated average gradient. Here, how to find out gradient on any one point when a graph is a curve. So for that, finding the instantaneous gradient is the gradient of a tangent at a point. So we need to draw a tangent like this. Example, a speed time graph of first 4 seconds of someone running a race is shown, that is here. So calculate the instantaneous acceleration in 2 seconds. So in 2 seconds, how much it will travel, that we will calculate. So let's see that. To do this, we will draw a tangent to the line after 22 seconds. So this is the tangent you can see here. And then to find out the gradient, we'll use the same formula, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1, and we'll get the value 1.04. So in this way, we will calculate the gradient for a curve.
My dear students, I hope this video will help you to understand how to calculate different parameters in a speed time graph. Before leaving, you must like, share and subscribe to your very own channel, Sony Singh Physics. Thank you. Thanks for watching.